Hello everyone, welcome back to the Geek Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're diving into the top 7 wiki tools that you can use for you and your team. In today's video, we're going to be going through these recommendations along with pricing and some of the key features. So without further ado guys, let's jump into today's video. Okay, so a lot of you may have been hearing about wiki tools and looking to jump on board, and this is totally not a new concept. This has been around for a while with applications like Microsoft SharePoint and Atlassian's Confluence. The goal of a wiki tool is to help you to capture useful bits of information that you and your team typically share, but also produce it for onboarding, to help with processes, and also ongoing learning. It's almost like your team's brain or your library. So a lot of people recently have been actually using these wiki tools as a bypass or replacement to applications like Google Docs. And even project management software is actually trying to build these wiki or docs-like experiences within their existing software. So there's a lot of focus on them, and teams are definitely looking to use them. Now, if you're a team looking at a wiki tool, this might give you the guide, but again, it's not suitable for absolutely everyone. So this is no particular order, and please do check the timestamps and list below so you get all the information you need to know. Okay, so the first one is an application called Slab, and it's a very well-designed application. It does look very attractive, and they have this very cool unified search feature. So what you can do is you can plug in your Google Drive, your Slack, and other such tools, and when you go to search, you can actually find useful docs and useful conversations that you may have been having and quickly find them inside of your Slab account. Now, of course, you can start building pages inside a Slab, so you can use your existing stuff you may have built in Google Drive alongside of the new stuff that you're building inside of Slab. Now, they do have some great administration insights, so you can see the types of pages and areas that are being built by your team every single day. So the pricing for this is fairly reasonable. Per month, it is $40 for 10 users. So that makes out about $4 per user per month. And that is the month rate. It gets even cheaper with the annual fee as well. Okay, so number 2 is Notion. I've talked a lot about Notion here on the channel. And if you're looking for a great course for it, we've made one as well. So do check that one out as below as well. So Notion is being used by many companies like Figma, Blinkist, and Lattice. And many people like its design. It has some great wiki abilities, allowing you to create very simple pages that can also be turned into advanced pages. And people particularly like the project management abilities that come along with it. You can create databases that turn into boards, that turn into calendars, that turn into tables. And they're very advanced, and a lot of people are taking full advantage of that. They do have a free plan which allows you to add lots of different admins so you and your team can get started. However, there is a 1,000 block limit. So at the moment, your team plan, if you look to go and add some members to there, it's going to cost you $10 per user per month. But again, Notion is probably the hottest wiki tool out there right now for both personal and team situations. Okay, so number 3, this is one that I'm still yet to do a full review on, but it's called Tettra. Now, Tettra has a range of abilities. It's a traditional wiki tool with the ability to add folders so you can organize things in a neater fashion. You can also get viewers per a page, which is very helpful, particularly for seeing who's actually seen each of the pages. They have a range of templates, but one of the features that I was pretty impressed with was a thing called page suggestions. So if you're a manager and a question has been added to suggestions, it'll pick that out for you. And if you're a manager, it will ask you to answer certain questions, which then allows you to build your wiki stronger and better. So that's one of the cool features that I do like inside of it. So Tettra is priced around the pricing of Notion. It is $99 for 10 users, which makes it just below the $10 per user per month mark. Okay, so number 4 is Process Street, and this is one that I always regard to as one of the more advanced wiki workflow tools. And what's cool about Process Street is you can create a workflow out of a process or procedure that you and your team go through typically. So this is from a range of things, from sales process to, for example, if you were signing a real estate client. And there are so many examples of this. What it does is it basically has integrations with it. It has over 1,000 integrations and allows you to connect them in with those workflows so that you can go and action certain processes. You can run a checklist. You can either start doing it manually or you can start creating automations to get that done in the background. It is a really advanced checklist and process management tool, and it does have conditional logic as well. This one is priced a little bit steeper at $15 per user per month, but we've done a full Process Street review that you can watch below. Okay, folks, so number five is Confluence. Now, you may have heard of Confluence, and that's because it's probably one of the oldest wiki tools out there. It's now run by a company called Atlassian, which own a range of products, including Trello. But Confluence looks very much like SharePoint and a combination of Notion. If they had a baby, it would be Confluence. And as you can imagine, it's a great way for you and your team to start adding useful bits of information. It's more popular with agile teams and software developers that already use an application called Jira. Now, the pricing differs per user, but it starts from free, and the starting of the pricing in the standard plan starts from $5 per user per month. Okay, so number six, and that is Coda. Now, Coda is a great way to start creating a document. It looks very similar to Google Documents. You can start building a manual for a team or a process, but it's very similar to the likes of Notion by allowing you to do basic and advanced project management abilities within it. So you could build an app or a bit of software inside of there that helps you do a certain task. And what's great about Coda above, say, Notion, is that it has automations and packs as well, which allow you to connect it to existing applications and integrations. They also have tons of templates, one of the best template galleries I've seen out there, and it provides you with some real-life examples from companies like Uber, Spotify, and many more. Priced at $12 per month per user, which is fairly reasonable, but their pricing is slightly different because you can have things called doc makers, and they also have a free plan as well, so you can get started and understanding the application. But it's quite an advanced tool, but once you learn it, it definitely has some strong capabilities. Okay, so our final recommendation is an application called Slite. Now, Slite is a very basic wiki tool. It looks really clean in its use, but it has a few features that are popular amongst users. For example, private notes, so you and your team can have a bit of separation. Your team can have all of the wiki useful information, and you can actually start using it as a miniature note-taking tool to some extent. You also got bookmarks on there, so you can save clippings of useful websites, also useful wikis that you may find across the day. And it's also got channels as well, if you wanted to separate them per department, which is something that you'd have to build from scratch from other tools, but channels helps you to organize that in Slite. So this one is definitely on the cheaper side. It is under $7 per user per month, which is fairly reasonable. Okay, so I want to mention two. They are Quip. Quip is, again, another great sort of Google Docs blend application that allows you to create documents that you and your team can find the useful information. To be honest, I need to do a bit more research and dive into that application, maybe do an updated review. They're now run and owned by a company called Salesforce, which many of you will know. The other application I wanted to mention is Airtable. Now, this for me at the moment, I'm not seeing it as more of a wiki tool. I'm seeing it as more of a project management tool. So I will be doing a review of them, but we do have a review of Airtable if you want to check it out. But I've seen a lot of people use it as a personal wiki. For example, Chris Dancy uses it as a personal wiki. So I don't see why it can't be used that. I just want to do an updated version of it before I necessarily include it in a traditional wiki. Wiki tool video. So folks, hopefully that was helpful. Hopefully you found a wiki for you and your team to start using. I'll probably start doing a personal wikis feature soon that you may go and take advantage of. But if you're new here, please do subscribe. If you enjoyed the video, please do like it and comment below with one that you may have found from this list. So thank you very much, everyone. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheerio.